Savana Lee, this is Anthony Crawford. We're Sugarcane Jane, and we're gonna just play you guys some songs. Y'all doing okay? Hey, Mary, Mark, Brian, good to see y'all.
That's why I wasn't playing. We'll do that again in a minute.
So we had some requests last time that we didn't quite do all of them. And we're going to try to do some of those and then throw some other stuff in there, I'm sure. Right?
Which ones did we not do? We did all of them.
The one before me was the only one we didn't do, I think.
We can do that.
And then we had some more requests over the last 24 hours. So.
All right.
All righty.
Well, let's just see what we'll
start
with.
Our flippers. Doing something
Flipper's
over here.
Doing.
Yeah, it is. So that's Flipper over there, and it's a live Facebook encounter. So if you go and like our page, that thing just like has a hissy fit, but it's fun to watch. Hey, Beth Allen.
Softer. I played that real soft, so don't turn it up. One, two, three, four. I feel it in my fingers. I feel it in my toes. Love is all around us, and so the feeling grows. You go talk to the crowd. I got a tune.
What do y'all think? Can you hear us okay? Or like, because I feel like maybe the vocals are not as loud as they should be, but.
So what are you going to do? Turn your own internal vocal up?
I don't know.
Since we don't have a microphone except for the phone?
We could just like move closer, I guess. Does it sound okay? Hey, Johnny. Johnny will tell us. Hey, Doobie and Ellen. Awesome to see you. Edie's back. All right. Hey, Leslin. All right, we got a party going on right here, you guys. Well, it's episode 9. I had to switch it to some coffee to start out. I might switch over to beer, but I was kind of beered out. You know, I can't do that every night. Starts putting some pounds on real quick.
Hey, well, I think Buzz is watching, and we should do like one of those songs off of...
Is Buzz watching?
I think he is. He told me he doesn't go, like, really go to bed till like 1.
Oh, really?
He's a late night man.
See? Me too.
Not really, but...
Not really. He's my early bird. Thank God somebody's got to do it.
All right. Let's see. Let's do... Just go ahead and just get this out of the way.
Well, let's tell them who Buzz is.
You tell them, and I'll get ready.
Okay. I don't know what we're going to do, but... So, our last two albums was put out by a great friend of ours, Buzz Kaysen, on Arena Recordings out of Nashville. And he also, we did the Dirt Rose End record at his studio, Creative Workshop. And the last studio album, Southern State of Mind, he's a co-writer on both of those albums. And... he's got a long list of credits. You'll have to look him up, Buzz Kaysen. But we're going to do one of those songs. These two are a lot of good ones.
Oh,
Yeah, boy. That was a...
It's your idea to drink this coffee, isn't it?
It was. It was my idea, but I don't know. I might need some water now, huh?
Well, I've got some water from a few days ago.
Mm. Well.
Try it. It's still warm.
Nice. There is a cooler beer out there. It really is actually still cold. It's amazing.
Well, there's
just... one of those Yetis. Yeti, I'm going to expect an endorsement. Did you see that? See how I did that right there? Uh-oh. Oh, my gosh.
Smells like the prairie.
Good Lord, have mercy. It's like Cheech and Chong over here.
Does look like a big old doobie, but, you know.
It's actually sage, y'all. It really is.
However, I thought that was a good joke the first night, and I thought I'd just try it again.
Well, it's a good one.
That's a good one.
Hey, Corey, Tina, Laura. What song is this?
Oh, well, Silver Stars. Thank you. All right. Well,
that song's just comforting to me, you know. There's just this time that we're going through right now. It's, you know, I have not been really watching the news or paying too much attention to what's going on. And
or sure, bathing.
Or bathing. Yes, I have definitely done that.
No, I know you haven't.
Very
but some
hygienic
people are,
person. Don't tell them.
I bet some people aren't. They're just like, wait.
But
it
no,
out.
This I know that what's going out there is just wicked, and you know that song just kind of makes you really, really think and just feel for anybody that's lost someone during this. This is just a terrible thing, but hopefully that song gives you some peace, because you know I think you do go to a better place, and there's spirits, there's other people. Just love the lyrics to that.
I wonder what is going on out there. We've been here at the house for, 12 days or whatever it is? I mean, when is this over?
Yeah.
I got no idea.
I don't think they're going to call us and say it's over.
Really? You're just going to have to just get in your car and go out and start just
Well, I'll probably
doing
have
it?
To watch some sort of news, or Grandma will probably tell us.
Yeah, well, I hope so. But I have to say that we've enjoyed playing out here in this studio and having the ability to reach people through this phone. I was talking to Buzz today, and he said, isn't it amazing that, you know, you have all these great microphones and just you buy all this stuff or whatever, but we're doing a show through a microphone on a telephone and reaching the whole world if, you know, ultimately this goes everywhere that... I mean, even aliens probably get this up there wherever they are.
Well, maybe that was what was going on.
Tell you what, I saw that light again tonight, and it was still bright outside. You know, it was starting to get duskish, and there it was, the only one up there.
Do you video it again?
No, it doesn't work. It doesn't work. Those videos don't work. I did take a picture of it and the other night, and I zoomed in on it and took the picture, but it just looks like something manufactured. But
yeah, well, maybe
I don't
is.
Know what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe if...
What are we going to do for them? Let's play on this song.
Okay, well,
to?
Yeah, me.
We're here. We might as well.
A house, not a home.
sweet song too. That Anthony used to sing that with Nicolette Larson back in the day. And there's a really, really cute video of them at Jamboree in the Hills.
But you just love that shirt I was wearing.
Yeah, it just kind of really takes you back to the 80s, doesn't it?
Oh man, yeah, it does.
I'm just reading the comments. Hey, Mom, good to see you.
Is your mom over there?
Yes, she's here again. Wow. And she loves that song. Thanks
really?
So much.
Grandma and Pop have just been really helping out.
Reese, thank you so much for saying that about, you know, donations. I mean, we're doing these concerts every night. We're not charging anything. But we do have, like, a tip jar. You know, over here, and if you want to put anything in it, the description of this particular stream, there is all of our little tip jar info there. If you feel like throwing us a tip, that's cool. We do have 3 kids to feed.
You would like to try something dangerous?
But I tell you what, they're still wasting food, and it's driving me crazy. I mean, I can only save so much or eat so much. You know, you just try to eat their leftovers because you just hate to see food go to waste, especially at a time like this.
Your dad would probably say, well, your mom won't let it go to waste. He's a funny man.
She hadn't had an empty stomach since.
I said, it's not supposed to take that on empty stomach. And he said, well, she hadn't had an empty stomach since 1967. No, I thought that was good.
I thought it was in the 70s. Well,
it doesn't. It was a long time ago. He's a
card.
You know, he's a smooth talker.
Yeah?
He is. Well, let's try this one.
Much.
you know, I just missed that one note, babe. Sorry about that.
What is that note?
I don't know. Like, I...
There you go.
Yeah, it all comes
back. Hey, what's a semitone amongst friends?
That's right. That's a tricky little part, you know?
It is.
Well, that's on, what's that on your, well, that's on our Southern State, right?
It is.
Yeah, Southern State of Mind. It's also on Anthony's Radio Cafe album, I believe. It's, you know, that's the cover that I, the back cover that I like so much. I don't know where it is now. You've hid it from me. Well, thanks again for being with us, you guys. We're
Did
gonna,
they all hang up?
No, they're here.
Yes.
And we're all just hanging out.
Well, oh.
By the way, if you didn't, if you weren't, you know, listening last night, we've got this new single out called Fellow Man, and if you go to our website at sugarcanejane.com, right there on the top part of the homepage, if you just put your email address, sign up for our mailing list, you can get a free download of that song or single there. So.
Some see purple and some see blue. What's right for one may not be right for two. Some need caution and some dare the pain. Some saddle horse, some stay inside. Some like to walk, some like to ride. Some learn fast and some learn slow. Some don't want to hear it, some have to know. Some go belly up, some ride so high.
Sometimes we win, sometimes we lose.
Sometimes we win, sometimes we lose. You get it, you get it.
Sometimes we drive, sometimes we rock the blues.
Really?
Some
may have it all, but I've got you. I'll forgive you.
Tomorrow is a brand new day. Another chance to learn to love and pray. You'll find me right by your side. Ready, willing, and able to try, try, try.
That's an old, old song I wrote years ago, and I thought, well, let's try to do that tonight. But obviously, we weren't ready.
Well,
you had it, and I didn't. You know,
well,
I'm just going to go ahead and admit that right now.
I don't have to remember how to play it, though, so see.
Well,
you know.
That's not the difficult part for me. It's just remembering how the words go.
Yeah.
And, you know, and I think that I live in the moment as much as I can, but I know later if you watch this show, if I just don't fess up right now. You'll just say, see,
we can rewind it. Yeah, so we always wish we had, you know,
rewind
in the house, because, you know, it's like, no, you said back, and it's like, no, I never said that. I'm like, rewind. That'd be nice, you know, it would come in handy. This is going to come in handy here. See?
Do you think so?
See what everybody's up to. Mark says we're all getting old. Well,
aren't you though, buddy?
Thank you, Dottie, for the tip. That's cool. Very cool. Let's put some money in the tip jar, okay? Right here. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. There
it is. Remember when we were singing last night? Remember when I had to run out real quick because Joy was barking and we thought that the kids were going to get up?
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah.
I mean, you know, in the back of your mind, you're sitting there thinking, well, we got, like I said, there's a whole nother meaning to monitor for us right now. We've got like a baby monitor over there. That's our monitor now.
More monitor, please.
I think it's funny.
It's a good one.
It is. Well, here we go.
All right. What do we have? We've actually, you know, this is the ninth episode, and we've, I don't think we've repeated a whole lot of songs. We're trying to do the requests, so you guys, you know, keep them up and remind us of our songs, if you don't mind. That'd be great. Hey, Wendy. It's been a while since I've seen some of you guys, and I know this is not exactly the same, but it's the next best thing.
Thank you.
one too. That one's that's from your National Treasure album. Mm-hmm.
Charles Court.
Co-write with Charles Court.
Haven't heard from old Charles lately, have you?
No, I don't know.
Been checking in, has he?
He's not up to date on these live shows. He would probably enjoy that. Charles is another sensitive, this is my sensitive man right here. I always like a sensitive guy.
An aqua velva man.
Oh yeah, baby.
Love me some aqua velva man. Burning stove. Well, I've got my first one. When we first built this house 10 years ago, we have a dog trot style house, and it's made out of some cypress wood, and I had a lot of scraps left over. So I was going to build me my first fire in the little stove, little black stove, you know, with the pipe going up through the roof. And
Loretta was just what?
Loretta was probably, what, 6 months old?
Something like that, yeah.
And so I lit the thing. I just stuffed it full of those leftover scrap cypress things. And I lit it, and, you know, I was feeling like Barney or something, like, you know, started getting feeling warm in there and everything, and went in there, and it's like, get me a beer, Bobby. I walked back out on the dog trot, and I'm telling you, the pipe was like completely red all the way up.
Yeah. Okay. Which runs like in the center of our house.
It runs through the center of our house, and it was just red, fire red, you know, and it just, and I was like, oh my God, you know, and I walked out.
Well, you just built this house.
Just built the house. I ran outside, and I looked at the top of the thing with that cap on, and that thing was red too, and I thought, oh my God, I have just burnt down brand new house. I mean, it was the most frightening thing that I'd ever felt. And so, I don't know, it was terrible. So, I think I wrote this song probably 20 minutes after that, but it was a rough night for old dad, wasn't it?
Yeah, and I remember, because Loretta was, she liked to cry a lot, you know, but I had just gotten her to sleep. I had just gotten down when fire alarms, like the smoke alarms, started going off, and she woke up, but she wasn't like crying. She was just like in shock. She was just like, her eyes were like that big, like, what the hell is going on?
Just scared times. We'll see if we can remember. I will recall you as close as I can. And then
I saw
red. It was smoking on the dog trot, making it hard to breathe. Sweet face, baby, and me. I said to her directly, "You take baby outside while I get the water." Pour it on the fire. I'd say I didn't panic, and it would almost be the truth. But the truth of it is that I did see my life before me in that blink of an eye. When I looked up at the roof and it was red against the sky, the water took the fire, and the future still stands.
Sweet face, baby,
one lucky man. Yeah. forget.
I opened all the windows, all the doors to my heart.
Something reassured me.
Something reassured me from out of the dark. I'm an unlucky man, yes I am, yes I am. How I got here, I don't understand. I'm one lucky man, lucky are me. I've got three monkeys in my tree, yeah, 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 yeah.
Note to self, go over that one too.
Go over that one, yeah. Well, you can hear it on our Listen with Headphones album. You know, we had a, we did have a,
this
another,
one?
Yes.
It's on there, see?
Yeah, there's another one. Somebody requested Songbird from that album as well. So,
wow.
Oh, we got a tip.
Wow.
All right, cha-ching. Man. Let's put some money in the tip jar.
Man, that was.
Thank you so much. Yes.
Ah, man.
Thank you. Right.
This is a lot of fun to come out here. Last night we finished the show and
talk to him. I'm going to go get a beer. I can't do I got to have one.
Well,
sorry.
Grab two, I guess. I'll drink one with you.
Okay. Well, I appreciate that.
But seriously, we walked inside and I was turning the studio off, and I went in there, and within 5 minutes, she's already in bed trying to go to sleep. It's like, now that's the way to do a gig. And, you know, well. So glad she turned that dadgum camera off. Buzz, are you still on there? Can you communicate? Hang on. Come read this thing, baby. Mark Allen, tequila!
And I should have asked y'all if y'all wanted anything from the kitchen. Uh-oh. Next time, you let me know.
Well, how many koozies you need? We got a bunch out here.
I don't know. I was just going to try to, like, promote some people. You know, like...
Oh, yeah.
Let's see. We got... Yeah, baby. All right. Thank you, Davis. We got more tip money to put in here. Let's see.
Look at that quickly. One, what? One, 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 one.
What? Are you serious?
Take a picture of it quick.
Now I'm putting money in there. Oh, that was a $100 bill.
Wow. Really?
My goodness. You guys, I tell you what, everybody's been just so supportive of us and just musicians. All around. There's so many great live streams. I'm excited because it's like we get to go to all these, our friends' shows that we never get to go to because we're always playing. But now we can just, you know, if we don't catch them live, we can go back and watch it, which is what you can do on ours. It's like the neatest thing.
Yeah, you need to get sick of us. Just turn us off, you know? Just go. Go.
Well, they could, but...
Don't leave.
Please don't leave. Please.
Is anybody still on there?
Cheers.
Cheers, baby. Thanks for going to get that.
You're welcome.
We had a very nice skit all planned out for y'all tonight. But
the kids would not go to bed till like, no. I mean, 5 minutes before we came and did this. I mean, it's just unreal. I mean, daylight savings time messed us up.
Yeah,
and then this, and just, I don't know, you know.
Thank you. This came from Edie, didn't it?
I think we need to run on more, you know.
We do. We do.
Get their exercise. Mm-hmm. Mm. Well, what do y'all want to hear, you know? If
let's get rid of this coffee cup here.
Get rid of it. Who needs coffee at 10:30?
Here. That's our little Dwight Yoakam coffee cups.
Yeah, and turn it to the other side. Dwight has a Sirius XM channel now. Channel 349. It's pretty cool. He's got, like, lots of cool guests that come over and sit in with him, which... who was it? Gosh, I'm trying to think who was on there the other day. That was Billy Bob Thornton.
Really?
Yeah, he was on there. That was cool.
Love me some Billy Bob.
I do too. Mm-hmm. He seems like a cool guy. Did you ever meet him?
I did not.
Mm-hmm. Who's the guy off of National Lampoon's Vacation that you went golfing with? That was...
Randy Quaid.
Randy Quaid. Yeah. He was the one that was like standing out by the sewer.
Cousin Eddie. Yeah, we went and played golf in Nashville quite a few times. And then he said, well, if you're ever in Los Angeles, give me a call. And so he gave me his phone number. And I thought, well, wow, that's strange. Somebody like that would give me their phone number. And wow. Of course, I thought he was about to change it, you know, so... I actually called it a couple of years later, and I had gotten the opportunity to play with, had gotten, is that a way to say that?
I think it's just I got.
I got, had gotten. I mean, I don't know why I talk like
I
that.
I had the opportunity. Maybe gotcha, it's just not even being it.
But anyway, I called him up, and we went to play. I mean, when we played in Nashville, we had really good close matches. And, you know, so then he asked me to go play at Bel Air Country Club.
Wow, and fancy.
Yeah, man, I tell you what, I pulled up to that place and, you know, I went in and I think went down an elevator or something and went into the locker room and Jack Lemmon's locker there and all these people that, you know, you just starstruck by. My goodness, look at these people. Went out on the first tee, and I mean, I just like duffed it over, hooked it over somewhere. It took me like 12 shots to get it in the hole on the first hole. Finally got it together, but the nerves of playing Bel Air with him after just seeing Jack Lemmon's, you know.
Right.
You know.
See, that's how...
I got
that's
stupid
how,
quick.
That's how I feel playing music with you, really. I mean, you know, I'm so not qualified. Yeah. But,
yes, you are. Don't put yourself down.
Okay.
Let me do that. Save it for me.
Okay.
Thanks. No, baby, I tell you what, you've done a great job. Now, I do know that this is why we're not playing the... What's that people's room of Mobile or whatever it is? We went down. That's where you learn how to play, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
You ruined that gig for us, didn't you?
I probably did. I mean, well, I had an hour of practice, and then we went and did the show. That was probably...
She had never played the bass, and I convinced her. I said, just go down there tonight, and I don't care. Just play it.
That was silly to do.
I'm telling you, you did a great job. Look at you now.
Well, I'm just looking to see if anybody wants to hear something.
I don't think anybody's on there anymore. Oh, we've lost a ton of people by talking and being
talking too
silly
much.
And all. Yeah. Oh, God, we're down to three.
No, we're not. It's okay, cause we're having fun. You know, this is just what we do. We'll be doing this anyway. I'm glad y'all are here.
Well, I'm sitting here high, getting ideas. I ain't nothing but a fool to live like this. Out all night in the running wild. I was sitting home with a month-old child. It's a dang man. Hang me, well, I ought to take a rope and hang me high from the highest tree. Woman, oh, won't you weep on me? Dibby, 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 dibby won't you wait for me? Coffee breath. I like it.
Yeah.
Mm. Well.
That song always reminds me about, like, getting pregnant. You know, it, well.
What are you trying to say?
Just that part where it's, you know, what is it?
What song are we just doing?
This will be the last time. This
oh,
will
that's
be
where
the,
you're drawing
maybe
in.
The last time. You know, oh no.
yeah.
Oh no. Well, baby. Yeah, let's not speak
no,
that
don't even
into
talk like that. Don't even talk like that.
We actually have, instead of a tip jar, it's really a vasectomy fund for Anthony, because we do have three beautiful, precious little children in there. But
well, my buddy Bill Bingham that I do play golf on Wednesdays, he said he could do the operation up there.
Fantastic.
Just bring some pliers.
On the golf course?
Yeah.
I'm sure that will...
That'll look good.
That'll look good out there. Well, I'll just go around, y'all.
Playing through. Go ahead. That's okay. I'm overclipped.
Ask the beer cart girl. She's got some ice, you know.
Yeah. You know what? I'm having a kind of a tough time right here. Oh, I know what it is. That's what
are y'all having fun? I hope you are. Thank y'all for being with us. What else can we get into here tonight? Do you think we could identify as the Darlins? Well, I love the Darlins. Anthony always calls them the Dillards for some reason, but they'll always be the Darlins to me.
Hey, you know, I think probably, you know, last night, did we play San Andreas for Scott?
Yes.
We did? Okay, we did that. You know, today, my friend that just had that, like, heart surgery and all that stuff.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He said that he watched the show from last night when we did Never Do We Know.
Mm-hmm.
He said he cried like a baby.
Aww.
I know. Aww. I almost want to play that. He sent me a video of when the Darlins were singing There Is a Time. He said, this is another song that makes me cry. I said,
oh, that song makes me cry, Paul.
That's some sweet stuff.
That's good, isn't it?
Let's do her.
You want
to
do that?
I'll try to hold her back.
Okay.
A one, a two, a one.
Time for love and laughter. The days will pass like summer storm.
beautiful song.
For now.
Don't get used to it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think it is bizarre, this whole thing we're going through. I've never seen anything like it in my life. But one good thing about... You're not even listening.
Oh, I'm listening. I told you I'm a multitasker.
Think about all the cars that aren't driving around. I mean, you talk about making it all clean and pretty again. I mean, at least you think about... I mean, there's got to be some sort of thing that says, well, you know... I mean, because we haven't started our car in quite a while, have we?
No, we haven't.
I mean, as far as, you know, you think about how much we've driven just weekly activities.
Hey, we're saving the environment just by staying home.
I think that's the real thing that's going on here.
Well,
I'm glad for the dadgum air to be so pure.
As pure as the white-driven snow.
Let's play that thing that we did for Leave On. You asked Dusty, and let's just play it.
I don't know what he's talking about.
It's Darling. Hang on.
What are you going to play?
You know, the little radio thing that we did, and the kids just...
Oh, yeah.
Man, it is just as cute as it can be.
Yeah, Bobby Dusenberry with WMNF. She has a show called Traffic Jam. I believe it's like maybe 4 in the afternoons or something. It's down there in Florida, what, somewhere around Tampa area.
Somewhere way away from where we are.
We did a little radio spot for her, and it did turn out cute because we asked the kids about...
All right, now just don't get all bothered by the... excuse me, baby, I don't mean to block you out. But,
no, you could.
Well, I mean, let me just see if I can get the phone in here. Here it is. Well, we had to do the thing like, hey, this is Anthony and Savannah, whatever, but then...
Ignore that part.
This is Savannah and Anthony with Sugarcane Jane, and you're listening to Traffic Jam on WMNF with Bobby Dusenberry.
Savannah asked our kids what they thought about the coronavirus, and here's what they said.
Hey, Dusty, can I ask you a question?
What?
What do you think about the coronavirus?
Not having any food and eating it while mommy eats it.
Like, don't waste any food?
Yeah.
Do you want to say a little prayer? Like you did at dinner? What would your prayer be?
Not helping it to go away.
Very good. Hey, Levon. Levon is my 7-year-old.
Yeah.
Yes. I just got to ask you a quick question. What are your thoughts about the coronavirus? What do you think everybody should do about it?
You just relax. They should just stay in their house. Don't eat as much as you can. You got to save your food.
Okay. Loretta's 9 years old.
Cut it.
What do you think is going to happen in the future? Do you think this thing is going to go away, or what are your thoughts?
I think it's going to stay for a little bit, and then like possibly more than they think it is, but eventually it'll probably go away. But you never really know.
That is true.
I mean, to tell you, that's pretty good right there. Levon says, I mean, because we were saying... I mean, he's like, you just relax. But
stay at home. Don't eat all the food.
We told him, it's like, hey, look, you can't be wasting anything, please.
Hey, I'm rationing our food over here.
Heck yeah. But, you know, it's a good lesson to have, like, all the time. It's not just the coronavirus vacation.
I know it. My one roll of paper towels has lasted a long time.
I know. I mean, it's just, it's amazing the difference of like, how we,
consumption and...
Hey, it makes you think about
stuff.
Give
the kids, like, this much food instead of, like, this much food. It's like, you eat that and you can get some more. And that's not a bad way to do it because they weigh so much food.
They certainly do. Hey, let's do something that we know.
Unexpected. You know what I want you to do?
What's that?
Sometime, one? But you may not remember that song, but I really want you to play that... 4-leaf clover song.
Okay, well, we'll do it tomorrow night.
All right, that'll be my request for the night. And write it down.
Okay, well. to do this song. Let me get
Don't forget our Facebook counter over here. Flipper, if you go and like our Sugarcane Jane page, it will make that just start, like, flipping around. Single for that album.
That one right there.
Oh yeah, right.
Have you seen if anybody wanted a request?
Oh, let's see. Oh, there's Buzz, one of our coolest co-writes. That was a cool one for sure. Y'all have so many though.
Well, since Buzz is still awake, I'll tell you what, he probably doesn't get up till maybe Well, he goes to bed at 1. Let's just see. He's got a lot of energy. I've never seen anybody that can go like Buzz. Mm. I tell you what, I bet he gets up at no later than 9 o'clock. Hits the gym. Comes home.
Not anymore. You can't hit the gym right now.
No, no.
That's really, you know, that's been a bummer for some people.
I've never hit the gym.
Yeah, we don't do that. You know, I always feel guilty, like, you know, if there's any kind of yard work or just
I've got natural muscles. I mean, look at that. Look that is that. A natural.
Yeah, baby.
That hurts. Don't do that.
Sorry. So we're going to do another Case and Crawford song.
I'd like to call it Carson Crawford. We did something somewhere where it got misspelled. Where was that, Buzz?
Buzz Carson.
It was, yeah, somebody introduced him. Buzz Carson. That's like, yeah, it's all right. Hey, anybody that's got a Beatles cut.
You better get their name spelled right.
Yeah, man, I'll tell you what. We were driving up I-65 and heard John Lennon singing Soldier of Love.
Yeah.
It just blew my mind.
Oh, that was so cool. Yeah, so Buzz's Beatles cut. It's on live at the BBC. You can actually purchase that record. And how awesome. If I'd have got a cut like that, I'd have been like, I'm done. You know?
I need to tell you. Let me tune this up real quick.
I mean, everything else is just like a you know, it's hard to get.
Yeah, his Pearl Jam cut was, you know, I don't know.
U2.
You know, it's kind of U2 and Pearl Jam cuts. Kind of close, but the Beatles got it beat.
Yeah. Isn't that amazing?
It is amazing.
And he's still at it. I think he's like, I know he's still recording because he sent some songs down here recently.
Yeah, he came down and did his new album that's coming out.
His albums are fantastic. I mean, I definitely recommend them.
I tell you what, maybe tomorrow night we'll play a track of Buzz's music if he'll let us. We'll have to ask him first.
Okay.
That'd be good.
Definitely.
Those
new songs he's got. Yeah,
they're fantastic.
Man, you talk about like making you cry. They made me cry. It was just so touching.
Yeah, no doubt. The one about Friends.
Oh, yeah, so good. Can't wait to hear that one again.
I like Record Machine.
Yeah. There's so many good ones.
Did I say all that right, Buzz? Did we get that right?
Thank you, Reese. Thank you for that.
Kidding, buddy. I love all the songs we wrote.
Hey, we're just like so happy y'all are here with us right now. I mean, this is a lot of fun for us. I mean, we're just enjoying the heck out of this. I mean, really, that's what we love to do.
And
so,
I'll tell you what, somebody just says, hey, y'all are going to play every night? It's like, heck yeah. Why not?
We have to, otherwise I forget everything, right?
Well, me too, obviously. I'm just having a real bad night tonight, but that's okay.
Well,
tomorrow will be another day.
The good thing is when you play every night, you really get strong. You get tight.
Yeah, well, we were playing out all the time, and then we just went on the Dwight Yoakam tour and came home, and you know, we had a few gigs. We had a great gig down at the Floribama. They let us come down there and have a show, like a ticketed show, and those people are so great to us down there. We went and
had a lot of snowbirds.
And just, we had a packed house, and it was a beautiful moment. They really trusted that it would work. I mean, they had more belief in it than we did. It was like, oh man, y'all, no problem, we'll sell it out. It's like, oh, can't bite the nails, but
yeah,
it was a great night. Buzz was there, he got him saying,
and then all of this
song
happened, and just all of our shows got canceled like everybody's did, and so this has been a great outlet for us to just keep playing, because when you write or when you play music, it's hard to just stop doing it. You just, you know, it's in you and you have to get it out. So this is therapeutic for us. And I tell you, I have felt much more like positive since we've been doing this.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
You mean like about the music or just in your life, period?
No, about like the current situation. Like, it doesn't, like, I'm not consumed by it like I was.
No.
You know, because I mean,
I don't have a feeling of like gloom and doom. I don't know why.
Well, I think if you have faith, you just like, you know.
Yeah, man, I tell you what, I just
gives you a pass not to worry.
Yeah, I tell you what, I guess that there's just this feeling that I get that something's just going to work out okay. You know, I just don't know what it is, but
right,
actually, that is why I say It's the most relaxing time I'll probably ever have it in the rest of my life. But it is in the most uncertain times. The uncertainty is stunning of what is going on.
But just to not have any obligations.
No obligations. Nobody's expecting us.
That's kind of nice to just like, you know.
It's great. It's great.
Right. It's that we do have to feed the kids and, you know.
Did you feed them tonight?
Yeah.
Now that was bad.
To drop tuning.
Yeah, as a drop. Top off and let's just
what
I mean, your jacket off. Take your jacket off.
My goodness.
They're all gone, baby.
No, they're not.
No, ain't nobody on there. Let's turn it off.
Yeah, they're still there.
Really?
Yeah.
How can you tell?
How can I tell? Well, this number right up there will tell you that they're, we've lost a few of them, but some
was
late night.
Was it because I was talking?
Probably. Carrie Morin, what are you up to? Are y'all back in Colorado? Carrie Morin, a fantastic blues artist that...
Hey, Celeste.
Just toured down this way. They're just kind of all over the place, but I think they're back in Colorado now.
Here, baby,
hunkering down like the rest of us.
Hey, we both wore green shirts.
I know, because I like to match you.
Well, let me take mine off, too.
Okay.
Don't tell them, but I'm not wearing any pants.
Now, wouldn't that be interesting? Anthony got this shirt for me when he was out with Neil. Farmers?
Oh, Lordy.
That's right. But I don't know what this is. Farmaid, I think. Farmaid t-shirt.
It was Farmaid up in Massachusetts somewhere.
Yeah. I wonder when the next Farmaid is.
I don't know. Well, since I'm going t-shirt, I'll go trucker hat, just t-shirt.
Go the full mile, huh?
Full just mile of just
Alabama
redneck, just down a dirt road's end.
Yeah. Well, you pull it off, though. You can just pull it off.
Oh, man, somehow. Don't get me mad.
Okay. Well, all right.
You know what's really strange about all of this? I've got my priorities set for thinking about, is this going to mess up college football?
I know you're thinking about that. And
I mean, this was going to be our year, man.
Well, we don't have TV anyway. I mean,
that's
we don't
true.
Have TV.
Who cares?
So.
Here we go. Let's do this version. How I originally wrote it, you know. Well, I follow my dream to the path of a crow, all the way to the music row. Fell in love when I heard her sing, so packed my bag in my old six string. I headed south in all out run. Arms of a woman and two daughters and a song. I built me a house at the dirt road's end. That's just how this story begins. No regret to the past I find. Started again. Call it
Sugarcane.
Called Sugarcane Jane. That's what
I thought song was.
Let's sing na 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 and turns, there's always a lesson out there to learn. I was a busting my heart, gaining no ground, like a rat on the wheel, going round and round. Come the time when I knew in my heart, had to give it up to get a new start. Never in my life ever felt so free, like a bird on a branch of a live oak tree. Keep your fortune, keep your fame, stay in my chair, with a sugar cane jam. Thank you. red old rain. Come from the love, we call it Sugarcane Jane. I'm going to do a song for Mark Allen. Of course, he's probably already asleep.
No, I think Mark Allen's hanging out tonight.
I don't think he is.
Us.
See if he's on there.
Mark, are you here? Are you here with us, Mark? The latter seems to be the consensus that people would like to hear that. And let's see what else. Did you do one of the chipmunk voices? I guess they're wanting to know if Buzz did. Buzz was,
yeah.
Yes.
Oh, God.
Oh, Lord.
God.
Well, just calm down. Buzz Kaysen.
Hang on. I got to get you a different cord. You're just bending the crap out of that one.
Well, you should have gotten me a longer cord to start with.
That's big old heel things you got on there. Just
Buzz was one of the chipmunks of Alvin and the Chipmunks. How cool is that?
He's done so many things. It's amazing.
I know it. It is amazing, you know.
Baby.
What? What now? What'd I do? Man, are y'all having fun? We are just having fun here. He was Alvin on the Chipmunks, sing the Beatles, and Urban Chipmunk. That's very cool, Buzz. You're just a cool dude. We're, Julie Witten. Hey, girl. So proud of you. You've just got two beautiful children, and then she adopted two more beautiful children. And she's an amazing, amazing person. Go look up Pedro's Prayer Warriors, which is what it's called.
Thank you.
well now. That was so good. I get to like just into what you're playing, and I just really forget what I'm doing. Sometimes.
Well, you didn't do bad. It was good. I mean, I'm the one who's kind of messing up all the stuff. You know, I'm just sorry. I apologize.
Well, you know, it's mm-hmm. people are forgiving, and that's what's wonderful about this is, you know, you're basically just hearing our rehearsal, and y'all are tipping us on top of it. It's just it blows
we have
us away.
Left?
It's unbelievable. We do, yes, we do.
Boy.
Hey, Christina Christian. She is
a
buddy from down at the Gulf, and have to check her out. She's got that cool Dolly song, you know, that little Dolly
song. That's
Parton
a great song.
Song.
They got that studio
video.
Down there.
Yeah, Sandy Roots
Song Festival,
and yeah.
Hey Buzz,
lots
that's
of
that
stuff.
Festival that you should come down and play with. Down at that thing that Nick's got.
Yeah, I think we're going to do something
somewhere.
Hopefully in the fall. So that'll be good.
Hey, you know what I'm going to do real quick? I'm going to do this. You never know what I'm going to do.
No telling what he's going to do, y'all.
Listen to this. Because I got to go get me another one.
Just like that, it was not
really
the wrong mix.
Oh God,
I love that song though.
I do. I
that's
like
gonna
it
be
too.
The next single.
Well, you know. Hey, do you think the kids went to your mom's house?
Hopefully not. Hopefully, they were. I'll check on them if you want.
What are they saying about you? Read
what?
That. I'm not kidding. You ought to look at that. It's like. I think it's Carmen on there saying.
Carmen says, carry on. Love you, Carmen and Roger.
Carry on. Love is coming.
Suzanne.
Love is coming.
Suzanne Schmidt. She's got that blue bicycle group, right?
Who?
Suzanne. Is that Suzanne, right?
I think so.
That does. Yeah, they've got that cool thing in Fairhope going on. So many musicians down here. And, I hope that y'all are doing some live shows, because we've really been enjoying watching so many people.
Ross Newell the other night.
Yeah, Ross had one, and
I think Christine and Christian.
Grayson's got some live stuff going on, and thanks for supporting all us artists. And there's a lot of other people that are hurting out there. You know, the bartenders, waitresses, sound crew, all of those people. We're trying to figure out a good way to help them through this as well. So this is all, as you know, very new, and we're just playing music. It's like music's a healer, at least for us, and so that's what we're doing right now. And then we'll, if y'all have any ideas, then
hey, would you please turn that light out off on the
right? Yeah, well,
yeah, it's out there on the porch.
Oh, that porch light,
please. I don't want to wake the world up. You still there, Buzz?
I'm not good at reading these because I can't see. Mark Allen, Visa Birds. All right. Do that, my friend. Man. Okay. Hey, Linda Gale.
Well,
Linda Gale rushing. And then there's Mark Allen. Mark's still around. You know, I think some guy like that would be asleep long ago.
Well, you know, Stephen Cross had said that we had been keeping him up very late.
He's such a great artist, and just, I met Stephen Cross. This is such a great thing about music now. Back in 1983, I was playing in the band with Neil Young and the International Harvesters, and I was out in the parking lot, and Stephen Cross, I was way off from where the arena was, and he came driving up. I didn't know this guy from anybody, never had met him, and he said, "You need a ride?" And I said, "Well, certainly I do." And he gave me a ride up to the backstage entrance and everything, and we've been friends for, how many years has it been? 83, 93,
like 25 years.
25, 30 years. It's funny how music brings people together all the time. You know what?
You know, I was thinking about, like, we've known each other for 20 years. Can you believe that? Anthony and I met in Nashville in the year 2000. So, that's hard to believe. And I was just I was a baby.
Yeah, you're only like four.
Yeah.
Well, how many years am I older than you?
Like 18 years.
Isn't that pitiful? Somehow when you get to this age in life, it doesn't matter. But
you look like you're so young. You have good skin, you know. Look at that. And, you know, bone
structure.
Should
I show them my assets?
Your assets?
Yeah. No, I'll show it later.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Save it.
We got a long show to do. 11, oh, wow, 9:30, 10:30, 11:30. We've almost played 2 hours.
You got another beer. So
yeah, let's
good.
Call this a night. Come on.
Really?
Those people have to go to sleep.
Mm-mm.
That's a beautiful thing about this. We can stay out here all we want. Did you just turn it off?
You know, I did that on accident where I didn't turn it off, but I can't see the comments for some reason.
Don't worry about it. We don't need to see them.
I won't worry about it.
You're
going to
turn it off, aren't you?
No, I'm not turning it off. I will. I can't see what y'all are saying anymore, but
why?
I don't know.
What button did you push the other night that just clicked us off of there?
The finish. You don't want to push that.
Well, you hit finish the other night. Hit all those
other
buttons.
Hey, if I ever do that, y'all just get back on our page, because we'll do another live stream, because I've done that. But we're rambling too much. Let's play them a song before they go to bed. Y'all are probably in bed, right? Isn't that what's cool? But people send us, and please do send us your pictures of, like, just hanging out and watching on your big screen. That's so cool to us. What are we gonna play? Oh, are we gonna tune up?
Yeah.
Too, right?
No, you're good. Yeah, let's tune up.
Yeah.
Since everybody's almost asleep, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, well, they can come and go, and that's what the beauty of it all.
You know what? I don't care. We'll just come out here every dadgum night we feel like it.
I know. Well, you know, Lord knows I need the practice.
Me too. I do. I think you clicked it off, babe.
Oh.
Just play anyway.
Yeah.
Thank you.
State of Mind album. Let's see. Oh, we don't.
Well.
I don't guess we. Oh, here. Here it is. I'm always dropping stuff.
Dang.
Yeah. I like that picture. We look so happy, don't we?
Yeah. Yeah, I remember those days.
The reality of this picture, you guys, is like we were watching all the kids, and we knew we needed to get a back cover, and we asked Grandma to come over and watch the kids, and I don't think I had a shower that day, have you?
Oh, sure. I always take a shower.
But, you know, apps these days really do help. So they put makeup on and just do all kinds of crazy things. But thank God for that. Because I was looking rough. You were probably looking good.
Oh, I was looking fine, you know.
Yeah.
Hey, I tell you what I want to do.
What?
You know, nobody's going to hurt us if we do this again. I love playing this song. It just makes me feel like I'm
I can't wait to hear what it is. What
it's
is
just we play it all the time. But, you know, I find myself just enjoying playing and singing this song.
Can't wait to find out what it is.
Really?
I'm being honest, yeah. Always. I was trying to get those comments back. See, look, I did it again where I swapped the view.
Hit that set thing that says stop.
I could write a comment there.
Get somebody to tell you how to do it.
Maybe if I write a comment, it'll start showing up. See, there it is.
Baby,
you
are so smart. Tell you what, girl.
Yes, tell me again. Tell me again.
I mean, that is impressive.
Grandma's back on. Wow, you're staying up late. Yeah, Mark Irish, feet of dig in a row of daisies and a piece of granite. Clever thing to say.
Oh, yeah, I know what that is.
Yeah, that's a good one. Okay. I like that request.
Okay, I like that request.
When we first got together, we did, Anthony did a recording for me. He really felt sorry for me, and because I had a hell of a time in Nashville up until that point. But he did a recording. We called it Red Bird, and it's basically the first Sugarcane Jane album. It was his songs, and he sang harmony. Sorry, I got the strike off. That's not a good joke, and I'm sorry. But anyway, this was possibly one of my favorites from that record. It's called Uptight Situations.
Running through the night in the rain. got large, small problems in the pull of the world on what I exactly gravitate to. Standing on number 44 like nothing's ever happened, and I'm still working on my moves. I no longer expect visits from most in it, but I believe the spirit that comes to bring me peace. Sometimes it feels like life is slipping away. Love tight situation, it rattles my cage. That it all goes dark as our last breath drawn floats anonymously away. Pulled up in a room all night into the morning, and I'm casting my nets into notation bay. Well, that old man in the sea, he's got nothing on me. I've got a big one tied to the side of my boat, and no one can take it away. Living down there no more, she gave me a swift kick out the door into an area cold. She sent me back down a heartbreak road. Well, the lights of the city so far away, I remember all the good times every day. I did a lot of thinking as I drove down to the end of a heartbreak road, and I'm quietly trying to get by. Chicken out back. I smiled as I shoveled up another load. Now, what do you expect from a heartbreak road? Well, I'm a quietly trying to live back here with nights of pride. I see you as a one man to me. Well, I'm a damn if I do and damn if I don't. It could be she still wants to hear from me. Once more. Well, there's a corn and a possum in the ground, a hole and a lot of horny toads. Road, I caught a bass and cat and broke my fishing pole with a pond on the road on a heartbreak road. Put a pond on the road on a heartbreak road. With a pond on the road on a heartbreak road. Living down heartbreak, heartbreak road. Living down heartbreak, heartbreak road. Oh,
case in Crawford, Anthony Crawford song, y'all. Heartbreak Road.
Now that's fun.
It's so much fun.
But that wasn't the one I was going
to
do.
Grandma's still here.
Huh?
Grandma, you know you're going to have to watch your three grandchildren tomorrow. First thing in the morning, they'll run over there.
Because we're going to the gym and the spa and having our hair.
Where are the kids? We hope they're asleep. See, you probably missed the first part of the show. When we say we need more monitor, we're talking about the baby monitor. We need more baby monitor. But we actually don't need more baby monitor. It's over there making noise, some kind of noise. But as long as kids aren't hollering, Mom, 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 hey, Mom.
Mom?
What we're going
to do tomorrow is take a video of what our day's like and then just show a little bit of it. Dad? No.
Dad?
Don't hear that much. When they said is, Dad, where's Mom? I swear to you, Dad, where's Mom?
That's funny. So, thanks so much again for watching. I'm Savannah Lee. It's Anthony Crawford, Sugarcane Jane, and... We do have a virtual tip jar. If anybody wants to throw us a tip, hey, we appreciate it. It is buying our children food. So we are grateful, and there's been so many of you support us, so thank you so much. But what is it?
I don't know.
You're starting to look a little stiff. Feeling okay?
It's my back.
Is it your back?
I can't move.
You're like the Tin Man all of a sudden. Yeah. But hey, what I was going to tell you, my thought came back to me. You know, there's so many people struggling, and if you cannot tip us, that is so okay with us. We're just having fun out here. But I'll tell you something that you can do if you want to help us, like just reach more people, just make sure and share this feed and comment and those little hearts that you can do. That really makes us feel so good, y'all. If you did that, that would like make me just glow. That, just follow us on social media. That would be great. Stay in touch.
What are you in? my back.
Eyes are back.
Help me up. Thank you.
I think I'm going to have to get him to bed, you guys. No?
Tell you what.
Oh. Well, we're having fun, though. I still have beer left. How about y'all? Y'all hanging out? He's got so many songs that...
I'm trying to remember some of the ones that I did today.
You know, I've been telling people for years he's got 400 songs. Well, he found like a whole slew of dats that have other songs on them. So who knows how many songs.
Expecting no gain, a returning.
Crawford songs right there. That's On the Edge. That's on our Ladders and Edges album. You guys, are y'all still with us? Doobie's checking out. He's got to work early in the morning.
How about that sign there, Doobie? That's a nice place for it, isn't it?
I know. We're loving our sign that Doobie made back there, the logo.
There's a lot of people looking, but few ever find. The other end of the rainbow, that treasure kind.
Huh? What?
There's a distance.
This noise around me never disappears.
That was weird.
I got my eyes glazing over, and my thoughts so far away. And I'm placing one foot in front of the other.
Is what I want to know. Do you remember that?
What song are we doing?
Noise.
I've already sung that out by the verse.
So that's it?
You want to hear
the
song?
Hey, you know what would be cool to do that we haven't done in a long time?
The song that I really wanted to play, because it was just so fun. Remember, we just like glazed right over that moment that I had.
Maybe I wasn't listening to you.
I think you were multitasking.
Probably.
Yeah, see? You want to do that song that I was going to do?
Did you tell me the name of that?
I did not. Nobody knows.
No wonder I don't remember.
Maybe we'll save it for tomorrow night.
Maybe so. Well.
Just cut it off.
Really?
Probably nobody there anyway. I haven't looked in a while, but.
They are there, and we appreciate y'all so much.
They're not there.
Are you going to do another song or not? Because I'm going to bed here in a minute, guys. We can do one more if he will play something.
I will, baby. I'm not being stubborn. Find out what the latest request is, and let's just do it.
The last request that we've gotten?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh.
Did you turn it off?
I think I turned the comments off again.
Dadgummy.
I've got to just...
Stop touching it.
I know, right? There. Happy birthday, Mark Allen. He's officially 69 as of a few minutes ago.
Really?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. All right, so we got... Louisiana and Fit In.
Fit In it is.
All right, Edie. This song's for you, baby girl. Is she
still on there?
Dang-a-lang.
Mm-hmm. Is she really? All right. Good night, Edie. Thank y'all for being here, and thanks for all the good times we're sharing here lately. We're coming out here every night just because we can. If you feel like tuning in, do that. But if not, we'll see the times when you want to come down.
Absolutely.
We just live like a minute from here.
You guys stay safe out there, and we'll see you next time.
Be safe.
Love y'all.